Man, Pinky.
Hello everyone, I'm here with a tutorial on how I'm making my 3/4 wig with the side bang. I haven't really done this before, this is my first time doing it, so I don't know how it's gonna turn out, but let's all hope it's really gonna turn out right. And I'm using this dome cap right here. I got this from Sally for about $3.69. This foam head is $3.99. And basically what I've done here is marked where how I would like the placement of the hair. Because when you're doing a side bang sewing, it's really different from doing like a regular U-part or a regular side part. So I just took my measuring tape and basically measured the cap from the side of one stitching to the side of the other. And I got about 22 centimeters, and I split that in two to get exactly where the middle is going to be at, which is 11 centimeters. And then I sort of like just figured out how wide I want my bang to be. If you guys can see that, like from the line back there, that's how wide I want the bang to be mainly. So that's about, let me see. That's about 3 inches. And then I wanted my leave out to be at least 1 inch. So that's why it's like 1 inch wide. And then back here is also the same length as the front, which is 3 inches. And I just basically drew the line back to like connect everything together. The whole leave out is going to be at least 1 inch because the cap is stretchy. When you want more than 1 inch of leave out, you can stretch the cap to fit your desired look or whatever. So yeah, and this part is also 1 inch wide, as you guys can see. So when I'm sewing the hair, when I get about to the middle of the head, right about here, I'm going to start sewing it all the way to the bang. And I'm going to go back and forth to the other side and then back and forth, back and forth. And if you haven't watched my video on how to make a basic U-part wig to get like more basic information on how to make a 3/4 wig, please make sure to check that out. I'm going to put the link in the info bar. And let's get started. Okay, so I've gotten to the part where I'm gonna start sewing in the bangs. I'm about halfway through with the wig, as you guys can see. So now the next track is gonna be going this way, and I'm gonna flip it over, go back, and go all the way around, and then come back and do the same. And I'm not gonna sew it all the way to the white lines because I wanna sew a track that's going this way, that's going to the left, and sew it around so that when I blend the hair doesn't look all bulky and crazy. So some people have been having troubles with their wigs. Some are saying that the wigs are not fitting their heads. And if you're using the dumb cap, you shouldn't have any troubles. But some people, when they sew in hair, they tend to drag the cap. For example, let's just say you're trying to sew the hair right here, and then you pull the cap from all the way up here to sew the hair. So you see how the cap is like pulling back, so the material is getting less and less if you keep pulling. And also for the sides, you want to make sure that you sew down the hair on the side nicely so that the cap doesn't pull either. So those might be some of the reasons why the cap is not fitting your head. And also, I left out a big portion of the back because sewing the back portion is not really important. It's basically any basic sewing. If you're really interested in the back portion, I would recommend that you check out my original video of where I made the 3/4 wig. I'm going to put the link in the info bar. And because the most important part of this tutorial is mainly the side part. And that's what I'm really mostly concerned about too. Because if I were watching the video too, I would just fast forward through the back part. And I don't really want to waste my time spending much time on that. And I didn't cut my tracks. I just kept going and folding, going and folding. Almost done with the wig, but the problem now is I don't have too much of the hair extensioners here left. I only have this much left, and I'm gonna be adding some of my indianhair.net wavy hair in here since I'm gonna be wearing the hair straight most of the time, or curl with curling iron or something, or flat iron. I'm gonna be adding the indianhair.net hair around this area, and I'm gonna be adding the rest of the extensioners hair towards the front so that I can be able to tell how well the hair blends when I do decide to do an update on the hair. So, and also I'm gonna be using the dyed indianhair.net hair, and this would give it a little hint of color, like a highlight, and if the hair sheds, I would also be able to tell which hair is shedding. As you all can see, I've exceeded the lines that I drew a little bit. And now I'm gonna add the last track of hair. the hair extensioners here. I'm gonna add the rest of it to complete the whole hair. And it's okay if you exceed the line because the wig stretches anyway. And also that allows for the least possible amount of leave out that you're gonna have to leave out. Finished wig, and this is the back, the side with a bang, and the other side, and this is what the front looks like. And I'm just gonna be cutting through the middle like that to where my leave out would be. And I'll be coming up with a video of where I style it and where I prepare my hair to wear it. And I think I'm gonna be sewing on some wig clips and to apply it to my head, because I think that would be easier, because I don't like to wear straight hair straight a lot of the times. I like to have them curly, so I can just take out the wig at night if I do use wig clips instead of having to wrap it every night. And that way, the curls that I do put in it with maybe a curling iron or a flat iron is going to be preserved. And now I'm going to take off the wig. And this is what it looks like. I'm just going to cut a slit through the middle. And then through the back part. And then you just cut off the excess little by little. And that way you don't have to worry about cutting too close to the stitches or whatever. And that's what it looks like. But I'll be cutting this excess part off. So actually, let me do that right now. And I'm just gonna cut the front part in a slant like this. And a little to the side. Just like that. And I don't cut anything else. And I do the same for the other side. And that's basically it. Gotta cut some more over here. And that's it, y'all. And I'll be coming back with how I'm gonna style it and things of that nature. So stay tuned. And thanks for watching. Bye.